Hello and welcome to yet another video on new features in release 7.4 of the Cisco Secure Firewall. In this video, I'm going to cover a feature where we tag a malware event with a MITRE tactic or technique. So this is new in this release. We've been doing it for intrusion events since the previous release, but now we're doing it for malware events that were detected using the local malware analysis conviction. So we put the MITRE tactic or technique in the event. Now, before I show you this, let's quickly review the techniques that we use on the firewall to convict files or check files to see if they're malicious. So the first one is a one-to-one, we call it. So it's a SHA-256 comparison. So we'll carve the file out of the flow, calculate the SHA-256, interrogate the AMP cloud, and if it comes back with a disposition of malicious, we'll block it or alert. So that's pretty immediate, pretty quick, a sub-second type of detection. It's real time. Spiro is another way. That's a static analysis, only applies to Microsoft executables, where you analyze about 400 attributes of an executable, and it's possible there to get a conviction based on the fact that an executable looks close enough to another one that is malicious. Local malware analysis is another way. That's what we're going to deal with today. So local malware analysis are some high efficacy CLAM AV signatures that are present locally on the device. So when the device carves the file out, it runs those CLAM AV signatures against it, and it's possible it can get a conviction from that. And finally, we have dynamic analysis, and that's where the file is uploaded to the cloud for analysis. Again, this secure malware analytics, it could be a local or a on-premise cloud appliance, but the file is detonated and analyzed, and from that, the file could be convicted as well. Okay, we're over on the FMC now. We're looking at an event view, but let's go over and look at the file policy and see what you have to have in place for that. So let's go to the malware and file policy. So under policies, malware and file. So I have one policy here. So let's take a look at that one. It's called block malware because, well, that's what it does. So we'll edit that policy. Now within this policy, I have a single rule. It's pretty basic policy. But it still works quite well. So basically, it's going to analyze every file type, every protocol. It'll have a block malware action there. And for the analysis types, I'm doing Spiro, dynamic, local malware analysis, reset the connection, store malware. It's pretty basic, but you have to have that local malware analysis enabled. So that's my policy. So now, based on that, I'm going to run a test, and I'm going to download some test malware. So it's not real malware, it's been malware that's been specially created for us to be, you know, defanged so it won't hurt anything. So once I download that malware, I'm going to go look at the events. I did the initial download a few minutes ago, so I'm just scrolling down to find that event. So here it is. So you can see here I have a file monitor event. Of course, the newest events are at the top. So you see the file monitor. And then after that, the malware cloud lookup. So look at the file monitor event. You can see some information about it there on the right, source destinations, etc. Scrolling down, you can see the URL. You can see that it was just a file that was downloaded. So nothing bad happened here that we know. Wget grabbed the file, so okay. After that, there was a malware cloud lookup. You know, if we expand that, we'll do the same, find the same information, really. Let's see the SHA-256. We'll see the URL. But again, it did a malware cloud lookup, and apparently it came back as the disposition was unknown or clean, probably unknown. So nothing happened. So if we scroll up, though, so 11:34 was that timestamp. So let's scroll up a little bit. There, 11:35, so about a minute later, hey, there's some malware events there. So if I look at those malware events, so this is the interesting one. This is a threat detected in file transfer. It says it's malware. It says it's the quackbot, or however you say that. This is SHA-256 again. And now the change here, what I want to point out here is those MITRE techniques. So the MITRE techniques are there in that event. That is the change. So everything else that you saw works just like it has in previous versions for quite a few years back. So nothing's changed there except the new MITRE tactics technique. So if I click on those, you can see this actually has 64 techniques associated with this particular quackbot issue. So Those are the new techniques. Now, that's the same column or same field we use for intrusion events. So it's not a new column. It's still called the MITRE column. So any event that has a MITRE relationship there will have information filled in there. And the change in 7.4 is that will now be included in the local malware analysis. And here I'm showing you can add the column. So we're adding the column if you want to. That way it shows up in the list here rather than having to drill into the details. But again, the same MITRE column that's been there in release 7.3 is here again. But now that column is populated for that those local malware analysis convictions. And you can view all the details from the table view as well here. Same 64 techniques we saw before. So I've demonstrated that new behavior, which is that MITRE framework, but I just want to reiterate how the system works from that point forward. So notice that after the retrospective detection there of that malware, subsequent downloads on that same system, the same FMC, same devices, will actually block the file. So we don't have to do local malware analysis every time. Once local malware analysis has convicted the file, you can see when I tried to subsequently download this file again, it blocked it. And I can show you what it looks like right here. That's what the block looked like. So I've just gone back out to my client and I'm attempting to download that same file again. And as you can see, it's being interrupted. The system is trying to retry. W gets retrying over and over again, but it's getting blocked again and again. So let's go update the events with a sliding time range so we get the current event at the top here. And you'll see that we have some blocks again. So there we go. There's a file resume blocks as it continues to try to download the file, and the system continues to block the file. Now, keep in mind, this is just for this local FMC deployment, FMC and devices that are deployed here on your premises here, my test system. It did not update the cloud with the universal conviction of the SHA-256. I'm pretty careful only to do that for reputable sources. So what'll happen is, probably because my file policy has dynamic analysis here and because that's a Windows executable, it will upload that file for dynamic analysis. If that file scores high enough to be convicted by the SHA-256, then it will be convicted worldwide. So it'll be immediate conviction everywhere. Okay, so that's a good overview of how things work, but I want to show you yet another view. I still think that the malware analysis view from the classic UI is really powerful here. So let's take a look at that. So we're going to go to analysis, malware events. So here you can see all the malware events in one spot. So this is a summary, but that's fine. However, my favorite view is really the table view because it gives you a chronological view of what's been going on. So I'll flip the table view there. And here you can see what happened. Again, newest events are at the top. So really nice. You can see at the bottom, there's our retrospective detection, followed by all those blocks that happened after we made that first detection. Again, once that first detection is made, the file is going to be blocked on this local system. And of course, scrolling way over to the right, you can see that new column, which is, of course, a new feature in this release. You can see the techniques. So the techniques are updated even for subsequent blocks, not just for the initial detection there, but see all those MITRE techniques in the list there. Now, again, one of the reasons I really like this view is the file trajectory view, and you can only really get to that here at this point. I don't think you can get to it from the Unified yet. But by clicking on the SHA-256, a little red, malware icon there, you get the file trajectory view, which, again, I just love this view. Very powerful. It gives you lots of information about the file. I've gone over it before. I'm not going to go over in detail, but you can see the trajectory there. You can see how initially that file was downloaded because it was unknown, then it was convicted, and subsequently it was blocked. So you can see the nice view there in the icon. Scrolling down, you can see a table view of all those events, and scroll was in there if you want to see the details. But great way to look at the file. You can also come back here and look at that analysis once it is analyzed by the secure malware analytics. So there you go. Now you have information on the new MITRE feature in release 7.4 for local malware analysis, and plus a little primer review on how file convictions work in the secure firewall. Thanks for watching, and as always, happy snorting!